So we have had John Hutchison on our side in this. He actually submitted an affidavit into the court case. So John Hutchison, the fraud, why would he submit an affidavit into the court case? I also submitted an affidavit into the court case as well, because of my visit to New York. So we're now going to touch on why there's been such a strong reaction to 9/11 and what's called the Hutchison effect. And I think there's been a huge effort to try and keep this covered up, attack everyone that's involved in it, try and discredit them, call John Hutchison a fraud. Now, Ace Baker was a supporter of Dr. Judy Wood. Ace Baker is a fellow 9/11 researcher. I haven't really put a lot of detail about him in this presentation, but you can find out about him on the internet. He did an analysis of that first impact video, the second impact video from the chopper, and essentially showed that it must be a fake because of various problems with the video, the frame rate, this sort of thing, and things that have been inserted into the frame. We counted Ace Baker as a friend, and he actually wrote a song about Judy Wood and about her research early in about 2006, I think that was. But then he came along and said, once we'd announced the Hutchison effect, only about 16 hours after we'd been on that radio programme and discussed the Hutchison effect in a 2-hour-long programme, which we've got on the DVD, for 50 pence, Ace Baker said he bought Tesla coils on eBay and he had, in a matter of days, reproduced Hutchison levitation experiments, which took John about, at least I think, 5 years to get going. He later admitted he'd made a fake video. In other words, he said that because his video that he'd made looked like the Hutchison effect, because he filmed things upside down and used magnets and stuff, John Hutchison's videos must be fake. Now, Jim Fetzer, who was also one of Judy Wood's supporters, saw nothing wrong in Ace pretending he'd reproduced Hutchison's experiments, making a fake video that suggests that Hutchison was a fraud. Baker said, Hutchison is a video faker, pure and simple. There is no Hutchison effect, I'm sorry. Hutchison makes silly upside down videos. In other words, he was claiming that when I showed you the levitation effect, that what John had done is he set up an upside down box, put magnets on the top, filmed it with the camera upside down, taken the magnets off, you know, out of view, and the things dropped down. But if you look at some of the videos, you can't be doing this because we've got one which is of a cannonball, and the cannonball is actually going up and down off the ground, 70-pound cannonball. But Baker has failed to produce the levitation of the cannonball, the metal effects that you've seen, the fire effects, the bending and flexing motions, which you can see if you look carefully at the can video, which I showed a few minutes ago. John Hutchison's got 500 pounds of metal samples, on and on. I could go on about him and do a whole presentation about him. In fact, there's DVDs of him there as well, doing his own presentation. Now, Jim Fetzer had been a supporter of Dr. Wood. He'd said we have to look at the directed energy research, and he'd had Judy Wood on his radio program about 50 times. So he claimed that he was a big supporter. And he sent an email to me, you have taken it for granted that Hutchison research is well-founded, or at least sincere. This is not true. I had known of John Hutchison's work since about 1998 or 1999. I'd come across it in a book by Albert Button called The Electric UFO. And I'd also seen a documentary made by a UK defence journalist called The Billion Dollar Secret. I think I might have a clip from that later on. Where they show John Hutchison's research in this documentary. So I was already aware of it about 8 years previously. Now, on March the 3rd, 2008, Dr. Judy Wood received an email from Fetzer which said, just between us, if Judy were to back off her relations with Hutchison, whom I consider to be a fraud, I think her standing can be salvaged. Whether she is willing to do that, I have no idea, but there is certainly an option which is available to her. We all make mistakes and have misplaced enthusiasm, but my opinion is that the absence of physical explanations the kind I asked him at the time on the air, he is most unlikely to contribute to our or her success. So Fetzer is threatening Judy Wood's reputation because she's talking about the Hutchison effect. But Judy Wood has no association with Jim Fetzer other than through this scholars group. There's no membership, there's no kind of fee that you use to join, there's no constitution as I understand it, nothing. So he's basically making a thinly veiled threat because Dr. Wood has made this association with the Hutchison effect. And he's essentially done this with me as well. Now, when you talk about this on the internet, this is a sort of reaction you'll get. This is from a while ago. Jeff was a forum administrator on Rivers Intuition. I've got the link there. I don't know if it's still up there. I'm not budging on wooden rails. Call me a gatekeeper if you like, but it's my gatekeeper. My gate and I'm keeping it. And he closed the thread. So when people were discussing this research, this guy came on, closed the thread. Now, editor, who was a moderator on the RIMP forum, which was, I don't know if it's still run by Mick Meaney, but it was at one time, and I don't know if Edinger is Mick Meaney, I'm not really sure who it is. Somebody had posted about the Hurricane Erin study, which we're coming on to in a few minutes, and he put on that thread, move to the pin, Ginny Woods, notice the S at the end, it's not Ginny Woods, it's Ginny Wood, and the rest of those truthers are on a different planet. I've seen them abusing forum after forum, doesn't name any forums or what the abuse was. If I catch any of them in here, they'll be banned immediately. Okay? This has been going on for probably a couple of years now, maybe longer. I've had another example of this quite recently, from a personal account as a friend. Ian Neal, one of the founders of the UK 9/11 campaign, and one of the founders of this forum, which I also helped set up in 2005, and I was a moderator on there for a while. He recently posted, secondly, Julie Woods is really bad at public presenter of science. Now, I've got a DVD of her, you can make up your own minds on that one. But that didn't really bother me. I've watched her DVD presentations, well, I didn't send him a DVD, he didn't ask me for one. So, I'll tell you that, he could have watched it on the internet. This was the bit which got me. I guarantee that a vast majority of her academic peers would agree with me that the way she presents her arguments in a lecture format is very poor indeed. And that's being kind. Okay? I asked Ian Neal how he could guarantee this. Had he collected email responses, in other words, had he got to find Judy Wood's peers and found out who they were, and got the, said, can you send me your opinion of Judy Wood, please? So basically, Ian Neal is lying. He can make no such guarantee. He could have said, in my opinion, she is a bad presenter of public, a bad public presenter, or her lectures are in a bad format. That would have been fine, because that's just his opinion. But he says he can guarantee that a vast majority of her peers would agree with him. He can make no such guarantee. That is a lie. So Ian Neal is lying for truth. This is what I got to post about this talk tonight. Judy Wood directed Andrew Webb's Aliens. Andrew is a good speaker, but too easy to ridicule. Hence controversies. This event was moved into a controversy. I think it got moved back again. So it's not to do with the evidence I'm showing, it's about how easy I am to ridicule, and the other evidence I like to talk about, the range of subjects. That's the most important thing. So this is the sort of talk you get. There's a load more. I mean, there's whole videos which have been made to discredit and debunk Judy. In fact, whole websites have been set up to do it. But I've actually had some interesting website visits, considering I must be talking garbage. If I'm talking garbage, then why are these people come to visit our websites? Air Force, Army, NASA, Navy, Boeing, SAIC, NOAA, which is the Weather Service, Sandia Labs, Los Alamos National Laboratories, USDA, Treasury, Department of Veteran Affairs, Buffalo, Center for Disease Control, CENTCOM, NIH, NIST, Port Authority of New Jersey and New York, Raytheon, and so on. I've also had visits from Kinetic and the British MOD to my website quite regularly. So they're all being lucky. Now, actually bit onto this. Now, one of the things that Judy Wood wanted to do was study the material coming up from the World Trade Center, because she was quite interested in these sort of characteristics of how these things are different and what it was doing. And you notice here, for example, we seem to have two smoke clouds, a white one, which makes a right-hand bend and goes off, and then this other sort of darker one, which seems to go in a different direction. She was interested in what was causing these sorts of things, and we think this is to do with the way that the material is breaking down after the destruction. It's an ongoing nuclear process. That's why it's what's causing these plume effects at some level. But then she wanted to look at this. Oh, I've forgotten the enlargement about. So there you see the sort of darker cloud going in a different direction to the lighter cloud. I don't know why it's doing that, but I suspect it's something to do with the material breaking down. But then she found this, which again, hardly anybody has heard of. How many people in this room knew that there was a hurricane closest to New York at 8 o'clock in the morning? 10 minutes? Yeah, okay. We'll try and get through it. This is 9/11 morning forecast. Where's the hurricane? It was a threat to New York. Could it be? In other words, if it was a coincidence, and it was that close to New York, the outer bands were on Cape Cod. There was dry thunder reported at all three New York airports, Newark, New Jersey, and JFK. Sorry, Newark, LaGuardia and JFK are the three airports. Where's Erin? It's not there, it's not shown on the weather maps. Why wasn't it reported? That's from space on 9-10. Now, if you were up in the International Space Station, this is what you'd see if you looked down on a hurricane. You're only maybe, I don't know, about 100 miles above the cloud tops, so you get a pretty